Yeah, today I'm going to give you a brief about how to program a control, how to write a program to control traffic light system, okay, in the emulator. So in the emulator, on the port address number 4, there is already an inbuilt traffic light system out here. So if you see the lights out here, they are numbered, already numbered, okay. So the first one is an if you see it's an red light out here, 0, 1, 2, and the yellow is 1 and the green is 2. Okay, let me just increase the size of the mouse. Right. So if you see, there is an red light out here, and then followed by it's not lighted up. That is why it's an, gray in color. But the second light will be yellow, and the third one will be green. So they are numbered like 0, 1, 2. Okay, and then 3, 4, 5 here. Right. So the here in this case, the green light is lighted up. That is the light number 5 is lighted up. Okay, and then you have 6, 7, 8. And you have an 8, 9, and then A. So they are all sequentially numbered out here. Okay, somebody's.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but my father has been detected as COVID positive this morning, and we have to leave for a hospital in 1.5 hours. Okay. Is it possible to take my Viva now?
Yeah. No problem. And what's your name?
Anvesan.
Okay, whenever you are free, you give me a call. Okay, I'll take you by bus separately.
Okay, sir. Okay. Can I leave?
Yeah, you can leave.
Thank you, sir.
So these are the LED lights. They're all sequentially numbered. So so there is a control word. So control word is like it's an 12-bit control word, because there are total 12 lights. So obviously it will 12 words means you will require an word for that. Okay, the MSB will not be used. So whichever light needs to be put on, so you will put an 1 there. Okay, so now for this particular case, if you see here, the red light is on out here, so 0 is 1, and here the green light is on, so that corresponds to light number 5. So then the bit number 5, it is again 1 out here. Here it is the red light, so the 6 corresponding bit of 6 is on. And then here again green is on, so the light corresponding to B is 1, right? So that is how it is all sequentially numbered, and whichever you want to switch it on, you can give the corresponding bit to be 1. Okay, so that you need to give it to output port number 4, so they will glow. So this is how it is there in 8086 emulator. Okay, so this is already inbuilt. You just have to give the control word, word, so that another the required bulbs are glowing. Okay, so this is the first one is the default one. The second, in the second row, what is given is all will be red. Okay, so initially you have to start with all red, and then excuse me, this is an sequence which has been given in the emulator, wherein sequentially each of the lights will glow so that the traffic is regulated. Okay, so you can make your own sequence also, just ensure ki the traffic is going on smoothly. So this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 5 set of different conditions have been specified already in the emulator. You need not use these 5, and you are free to use your own conditions also. So these 5 sets of conditions have been given in the emulator. Okay, so the program would go like this. The port address will be 4. So initially you will have to use this syntax, so that the program fetches the emulator program, right? The traffic light program. So start traffic light underscore lights dot exe, so that it includes that stepper motor program also, and then you use the out instruction and give the just using the out instruction, you can give the make whatever required lights to be switched on and off. Okay, and now to use the there is an you need to have some time gap between the lights which is being switched on and off, right? So you need an delay program. So for the delay we are going to use 15H, okay, that is the interrupt 15H, and H is equal to 86. Okay, this 15H, a few instructions we did in the last few experiments, right? So this time we are going to use int 15H and H is equal to 86. So what does this do? Okay, once you call for 15H interrupt, so before that you need to load AH register with 86, and also you need to load CX and DX. Okay, so what is the values to be loaded in CX and DX is that depends on the delay time which you require. Okay, so the value of CX and DX, okay, will decide the total microseconds, okay, after which the program will return back. So so once you call for this interrupt, okay, the a counter within would start, and then it would return back to the main program after CX and DX total becomes zero. Not parallelly CX and DX, okay, that this total figure, okay, those many microseconds after those many microseconds, okay, that means for I can give you an example so it will be clear. Suppose you want 2 microsecond delay, okay, so what we need to do is you have to put an 2 microsecond is equivalent to, okay, 1E8480. So this is the hexadecimal equivalent of 2 second. In fact, 2 second, right? If you require an wait second of 2 seconds, so this is going to make in those many microseconds, right? So you have to put into 2 to the power of second 6. Is it understood or it's confusing? Okay, let me tell you. Whatever is the value of CX into DX, those many microseconds delay will be introduced by this interrupt program. So suppose I require 2 seconds delay, then I have to put the value of CX 2 into 10 to the power of 6, because CX and DX value and those many microsecond delays will be introduced. So you have to put 2 to the power of 6. Okay, so 2 into 2 to the power of 6 will be 1E8480. So you have to put 8480 into DX and 1E into CX. Okay, so 001E into CX and 8480 into DX. So if you put this initially into these registers, and then AH is equal to 86, and then call for interrupt, then you will introduce an 2 second of delay. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Yeah. Okay, then we move to this program. So this is how a program looks like. So first, initially, you know, to initializes the we'll have to initialize the virtual traffic signal. So this is the command, and then move AX and all red. Okay, now what is all red? That is given here, this byte is given here, and there are 1 2 3 4 5 situations. Now these 5 situations, you can look at the traffic light, how it is working, and you can make these 5 situations, or you can take the default 5 situations which has been specified by the emulator. Okay, so these 5 situations. So first we move the first this condition into the register, and then we move it out into the port 4. So port 4 corresponds to the traffic light. So accordingly, as per this situation, that light would be glowing. Those specific lights would be glowing. Okay. After that, to introduce the delay, so depending on now it says ki you need to have 5 seconds delay. Okay, so you need to compute the value of CX and DX. Okay, what is, I have shown an example of how to compute the value of CX and DX for 2 seconds. Now for 5 seconds, what is the value? So that you need to compute and place it here, right? And then once you have done that, and in AH you need to put 86H, because that goes along with the interrupt command. So after putting AH, you call for the interrupt 15H. So that will introduce. So based on the values which you have put in CX and DX, it should be introducing a delay of 5 seconds. Okay, once that is done, then you go for SI, increase the SI by 2, right? Okay, because in SI initially you have here, if you see in SI initially the first location of the first situation or first data has been put. Now you are doing SI plus 2 because it is all a word out here, so you need to increase the SI by 2 to get the next word, next situation, okay, or the next condition. So you increase SI by 2. And then you compare SI with SI end. So that is to see to it that you have come to the end of the data. So in the end of the data, you can put SI end is equal to dollar, which indicates it's the end of the string. Okay. So it will compare SN, and if it is jump, if below to the next, that is it will jump to the next. Okay. And then the next data will be fetched. So this will go into the loop. So all the five datas will be fetched one by one with a delay of 5 seconds in between. So once that is done, you can also do a move SI. Once it comes out of that loop, okay, then you have to again go load the first situation, because once these five conditions are done, again you got to start from the first condition, right? So again you can move that the location of the first data, that is an offset location, into the SI and jump next. Again you come to the inner loop. So there are two loops out here. So this is how you write a program for the traffic controller, so, right? So this you will do it, and you will display it in the so in the next class you will be showing it. So let me now just show you a small demonstration also. So it's there in the example itself, traffic light. So if you emulate it, so if you see these are moving. So this is based on the default things which are given already here, the control words. Okay, so if you want to try out something new, you can change this sequence and see what happens out here. Just ensure that that traffic is moving smoothly. Okay, so so with that, we stop this class out here.